Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome to another great ASD episode, App Store Domination. And today we are going to talk about extensions. So let's get to work. Now, what are extensions? Well, if you recall programming, there are a lot of classes provided by Apple, or even if you create them, and you can add extensions to them. So today we are going to create one of those extensions, and more specifically, we are going to create a UI color extension. Okay, let's get to work by opening up Xcode and let's create a new project here. Create a new project Xcode file. It will be a single view application and I will call this okay. And let's click on next. I will drop it onto the desktop and I will just uncheck create Git repository because this is a simple project. We are not going to create any backups for it or even upload it to GitHub. So here we are inside our project. Let's select our view controller and inside the view did load, let's add our view views background view a dot background color equals, let's say, dot purple. And now let's select our iPhone 10 simulator and build and run. Okay, let me just resize this so you may see our simulator here. And here we are. We have a purple background. And if you know some Swift coding, you know that this dot syntax comes from UI color dot purple. Okay, this is how you can add a default color that is specified by Apple. Once again, if I just type in here like so, we can create a UI color with a hue and saturation, named with a red, green and blue and alpha value, with a white and alpha value and so on. Okay, most importantly, we are going to focus now on this red, green and blue and with alpha value. Now, these are CG floats. So let me just open up here Photoshop. So you may see what these red, green and blue and alpha values mean. Okay, let's create a new project. And it doesn't really matter. Let's just create this one. And now I will just select, well, let's see this bluish color, and I will just open up our color picker. And if you can see here, we have a red value of 0, a green value of 114, and a blue value of 188. Now, these values come from 0 to 255, and this is how the colors are created here. If I just drag and drop here and move this around, you see that all these red, green and blue values change. So let's go back here and copy our numbers out. And 0, it means that 0 multiplied by 255. Next up we have, let me just take this up here, 114 divided by 255, and the blue one is 188 divided by 255. Okay, and now for the alpha value, that is our alpha channel, how transparent this should be. So for now I will just set this to 1.0 because I want it to be not at all transparent. So let's build and run again and see that now we will have this bluish black background. at an F value, and as you can see, the bluish color is a little bit darker. Okay, let's set this back to 1.0, and you will most probably always want to have this alpha value as 1. And what I really don't like about this constructor is that I always have to type in, just spin and run again this. So I always have to type in this divided by 255. So we are going to create an extension here. So what does an extension look like? Well, you just simply type out. And now you will need to provide some code, some, well, let's say helper function to make this UI color look like. And wouldn't it be easier if I could just type in here? And for the green, just a simple G, and what was the 114, I believe, and for the blue, 188, and without any alpha values. Wouldn't it be great? So just add these three values and you are off. Well, with extensions you can do that, and of course, because we haven't created our extension yet, we have an error here. So let's create it now. Okay, here we first of all we are going to create a convenience public function that will house the alpha value too. So, and we are going to add here our red, it will be a CG float. Our green CG float and blue CG float, and of course our alpha value here as a CG float again. And inside our function we are going to type in self init and init, and we are going to use the other constructor we have just seen here, back here, and let me just type this out again. So we can simply copy this out. So here we have it, red, green, and blue. So I just paste this in here, and for the red, I will just type in here R, G, B, and A. Okay. And let's just build and run. And what is the problem? Yeah, we don't need this function. Okay, let's build here. And of course, we don't have our UI color here available. So I just replace with this with a red for now. So let's build again, and we should have a build succeeded. Now that we have this convenience initializer, we can go ahead and let's say type in UI color, and now let us just find this RGBA, and we can now add our values. But I don't want to add 0 divided by 255, so I just simply add here 255 divided by 255 and 255. And now I just simply need to add those values from Photoshop. Let me just open that up again. So what I want to do here is 0, 114 and 188. And for the alpha value, of course, 1. And if we build and run again, you will see that we have that simple bluish background. But once again, I want to, as I told you, I want to get rid of this alpha value if I wanted to. So what I will do here is, well, maybe let's make another convenience in it, or maybe just use this equals 1. Okay, and maybe make it an optional. I believe that is the way to go. So let's start all over again, and let us just type in, let's build for now. Okay, I don't need that optional. So UI color, and if I just go back here, you will see that I already have two convenience methods, and I will just simply choose this one. So 0, 114 and 188. And that is all you need to do. Let's build and run again with command B, and you should see that beautiful blue color. And there you have it. You now you know how you can create extensions. Of course, you can create extensions for UI views and everything in between, or everything you want to add a new convenience public initializer. Okay, hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and play around with extensions. And as usual, I will see you in the next one. Good stuff. Now, if you want to see more of this video and want to boost your app business, go ahead and take a look at my 30 days challenge, App Store Domination. Go ahead and click the link down below, and I will see you inside ASD, App Store Domination. Let's get to work.